Gender and sexuality are complex ideas. We are still trying to understand, cope, and accept. Even within the queer community, there's a segment that is heavily misunderstood, shamed, and misjudged. Trans men. We are meeting my good friend Mridul today to understand where the lines blur between trans and cis. More importantly, how to ask a trans person the right questions without offending them. I wanted to understand from you, trans men are simply men, no? I mean, they're just men.
Trans men are men, yes, you're right there. And aise actually, I also know of friends जो ट्रांस मैन नहीं यूज करते हैं अपने लिए,
वो लोग बोलते हैं कि मैं आदमी हूँ।
हाँ, उनका आइडेंटिटी जो है वो मतलब वो जो टर्म यूज करते हैं मैन यूज करते हैं। वी से ट्रांस मैन बिकॉज दे आर ऑल्सो डिफरेंट फ्रॉम सिस मैन।
सिस मतलब वो जो नर्स ने कहा कि मुबारक को लड़का हुआ है और बड़ा होके भी वो बोलता है कि मैं लड़का हूँ।
ज्यादातर लोगों के बारे में जो भविष्यवाणी उनकी होती है बेटा या बेटी वो सही निकलती है। ज्यादातर लोग जिनको वो बेटा बोलते हैं वो लड़के होते हैं, जिनको वो बेटी बोलते हैं वो लड़की होते हैं। सबके साथ ऐसा नहीं होता। कुछ ऐसे होते हैं जिनको नर्स ने बोला रहेगा कि मुबारक को बेटी हुई है, लेकिन एक्चुअली वो लड़का है, राइट? ट्रांस मैन।
सुमृदुल, हम पूछ सकते हैं ना, मतलब तुम अगर कोई आके तुमसे पूछे कि यार तुम ट्रांस हो, क्या तुम आदमी हो या औरत हो, इज इट ओके? बिकॉज हमारे दिमाग में सिर्फ एक चीज है कि अंदर क्या होगा, whether this person has a penis, whether this person has a vagina, और सबसे बड़ा तो ये सोचते हैं उनके पास तो दोनों होता है करके।
Like short answer, no, it's not okay.
It's not okay.
No, it's not okay. You can't ask. See, what आप अगर address करने का सवाल है कि कैसे address करें किसी को, pronouns पूछ सकते हैं और actually pronouns पूछना चाहिए। I don't know ज़्यादा लोग क्यों नहीं पूछते। आपके लिए कौन से pronouns मैं use करूँ? आप कौन से pronouns से identify करते हैं, prefer करते हैं? वो पूछना एक अलग चीज़ है। ये पूछने से कि बॉस तुम्हारी body में क्या है? So I actually very lucky in certain ways. I have this very loving, very
endearing,
adorable family. Like they all really let me be. मैं उनको ये बोल पाया कि मुझे ये जो आप कपड़े मेरे लिए खरीदते हो मुझे पसंद नहीं है, मुझे पैंट शर्ट पसंद है। इवन स्कूल में एक्चुअली आई कुड नेगोशिएट कि मैं ट्राउजर्स पहनूंगा, कि मैं बीमार रहता हूँ सर्दियों में बहुत, बिकॉज आई वॉज बोर्न
बॉर्डर स्कर्ट में।
हाँ, स्कर्ट में ऐसे हवा जाती है, करेक्ट। तो मुझे डॉक्टर से नोट वगैरह लिखा के लाया कि मुझे आप पैंट पहनना है, अलाउ कीजिए। तो एक्चुअली किया उन्होंने।
You're privileged in many ways. So if all trans men are so privileged, why don't they come out and say they're a trans man?
The privilege comes from being read as a guy. In one word, do trans men have access to the male privilege in situations? Yes, they do have access to male privilege. I have experienced it. I'm also trying to say that that privilege doesn't work the same way in all situations. There's a lot of stories of harassment that we all know, getting beaten up, getting locked up. If you sort of try to run away with the person you are with your lover, then a police complaint is made. So I'm talking about two people assigned gender female at birth. When they run away, so the police complaint is made, and in that police complaint, the one who looks more masculine is the one who made the other one run away. So actually quite a few times, so this sort of more masculine looking person identifies not necessarily trans men, but sort of transgresses that gender thing. The thing that I said about my family earlier, about them being, you know, very accepting, giving me a lot of space, that didn't just happen overnight. The problem happens when you start growing up, right? So when your body starts developing, then जो आपका freedom होता है ना, वो tomboy की तरह रहने वाला, कि खाली एक t-shirt पहन के कभी भी निकल जाओ, या कितने ही छोटे shorts पहनो, like who cares? कि शाम होने से पहले, ऐसा 5 बजे से पहले घर आना, ऐसे कोई rule नहीं होते हैं when you're younger, when you're seen as a tomboy. लेकिन फिर आप बड़े होना शुरू होते हैं, which is a particularly confusing time.
So have you ever had this phobia कि मेरे पास breast ना हो तो अच्छी बात है?
That totally dominated all my thoughts till the time I had my surgery.
क्या surgeries क्या-क्या होती हैं?
So multiple होते हैं और सब लोग सारे surgeries नहीं करवाते हैं. you also have to understand.
So, jiska surgery hua hai, wo transman hai?
No.
जिसका सर्जरी नहीं हुआ है वो भी ट्रांसमैन है अगर आप कहते हो
no role to play.
That doesn't have anything to play.
No role to play. If you say you are a transman, you are a transman.
यानी कि मैं जो कहता हूँ वो सच है.
वो सच है. You imagine जब आप सुबह में उठ के शीशे में अपनी शक्ल देखते हो, like you feel like a stranger is staring back at you. You don't recognize the person you see. In my case, till the time I had sort of some medical intervention done and I got some mental health support to sort of be not as affected, मेरे घर में एक शीशा नहीं होता था.
Can you take me through what really happened when you had your surgeries done?
ऐसा एक काफी लोग ऐसा मेरी फैमिली के दिमाग में भी ऐसा कुछ टाइम पहले तक था कि तुम ऐसा ऑपरेशन थिएटर के अंदर जाते हो एक तरह की बॉडी से
और ऐसे बदल के
और पूरे बदल के ऐसा बाहर आ जाते थे, टाइम मशीन से बाहर निकल रहे हो. ऐसा नहीं होता है. इट्स अ स्लो प्रोसेस. जो ट्रांजिशन होता है वो बहुत स्लो प्रोसेस है. धीरे धीरे आपकी बॉडी में चेंजेस आते हैं. इट कैन टेक ईयर्स, even up to a decade for all the changes to completely happen. Medical interventions of course surgical bhi hote hain, non-surgical bhi hote hain, aur dono part hain transition ka. But then again I want to also highlight ki not everybody goes through everything. In terms of the medical interventions, of course HRT is one, which is hormone replacement therapy.
To hormones dalne se matlab doesn't it completely F up your system when you add hormones and stuff?
No, मतलब ऐसा market से खरीद के खुद थोड़ी inject करें. It's not like a drug or anything, right? So they take your history, they look at any past illnesses that you've had, anything that can get affected. And when you start, you keep on getting monitored. तो अगर कुछ problem होता भी है, dose adjust करना है, कम ज़्यादा करना है, जो भी है, so then the doctor is there. उससे क्या होता है, कुछ changes, जो external changes होते हैं, जो secondary sexual characteristics जिनको,
यानी कि दाढ़ी
हो गई, आवाज़ बदल गई, body hair. So that's one. The skin changes. Even actually the body smell changes. I noticed like my body, the not body odor in that sense. Like,
yeah, but right? but the scent, general the that, general the body, changes. Her body ka ek scent hota hai.
Haan, that changes.
What about periods? Yeah, I mean, do trans men get periods?
Most trans men will have periods till they undergo medical transition. So once you start HRT, after a while they stop. Then in terms of surgical interventions, you have top surgery, which is mastectomy.
The breast nikalne ka.
Nikal dete hain, correct. You have hysterectomy, which is removal of ovaries, uterus, fallopian tubes. Then there is bottom surgery. Bottom surgery is not one surgery.
Also, do trans men get erections and do they ejaculate and stuff like that?
The results are not same with everyone, right? There are people who have reported that they can feel erotic sensation even after the surgery. They can get an erection and they feel erotic sensation. There are people who can't. There are people who have had even more complications. So it really depends on, you know, how your body heals, which doctor you go to, how many surgeries have they done before that. But bottom surgery is particularly very, very expensive. Not many people can afford it. Very, very few people can actually afford it. The questions that you will not ask your cisgender friends, you shouldn't ask your transgender friends. You also have to understand what makes you you is not the fact that you are a man or a woman. What makes you you is this series of events that have happened right up to that point, right? With something we call lived realities. And you have to acknowledge that a trans person's lived realities are going to be very different from a cis person's lived realities.
So the basic rule is don't assume, don't put them in preconceived boxes, and their truth at that moment is the truth that they tell you. The truth can be the fact that today Mridul calls himself a trans man, tomorrow he might just want to call himself a man. He has the right over his body and the way he wishes his body should be perceived.